five-letter word for stubborn. Okay.
London seemed rather dull without you, and the Paris weekend was the last gasp. I missed you.
Oh, what a wonderful idea.
Well, from what Jill said you had planned, I thought you could do it.
Yes, it's certainly a lot of work. I'd whip up a batch of scones if the oven was working.
Yes, I didn't behave very well the day I left, did I? Sure you went to a lot of trouble.
I gave them to garbage guts across the corridor.
Oh, I'll tell her that next time I see her.
Oh, she's the first to admit it. How was London?
Cold, grey, very depressing. You weren't there.
Oh, you're good for a girl's ego. I missed you too. I was so worried after you'd left that I'd scared you off. With the pep talk the night before. I spent 2 weeks giving myself an ulcer, worrying about something you don't even remember. I got on my soapbox about lost ideals.
Oh, right. I've lived through 2 bouts of jet lag since then. I'm glad you worry about what I think.
I'm glad you're glad.
Sounds a wonderful idea to me.
Oh, I don't want to be stuck in the country. Besides, I'd miss the beginning of the opera season. If I pay for tickets, I like to use them.
You're talking to your old mate Charlie, darling. You're doing exactly the same thing you did the other day. At the barbecue. Not wearing the dress. Well, you're scared to death of getting involved with David. I can't for the life of me see why, the way things are between you and Gordon.
I didn't wear the dress because it wasn't appropriate for a poolside party.
Well, nor was the outfit you did wear. It was the drabbest thing I've ever seen you in. Face it, my love, you're backpedaling at a rate of knots.
I'm sick of...
And that's the only reason you won't go to Mumbai. You know what's going to happen if you're there with David.
I was going to wear the dress, but I changed my mind because it looked exactly what you intended it to be, the first step in a seduction routine. And if I go down to Mumbai, you and everyone else are going to think that I'm chasing him.
The fact you're so paranoid proves you're feeling guilty.
Oh, I don't know why I bother discussing it with you. You just twist everything I say. I'm not scared of working with David. We're both adults. Nothing will happen. I just don't want everybody getting the wrong idea.
That's not what you said before. A couple of minutes ago, you were worried about your opera tickets. I never know when to shut up, do I? Mind you, I'm usually right.
Pleased to meet you, Scott.
Now, Fiona's been telling me about the problems you've got with the strike.
Still, the money I make here will keep us going. Started the party without me.
We couldn't wait.
Now, look, you don't have to hang around here if you don't want to. I can keep going on my own.
You don't mean there's just the two of you?
Oh, I'm just pottering. In a few days, there'll be workmen coming out from the town. Oh, there's some coming up from Sydney, too. The plumber and the electrician. Oh, yes, and the decorator. I don't know what the locals are going to make of him. They probably think he's just artistic.
Well, I certainly can't just sit around and watch if there's only two of you.
Don't be stupid.
No. I feel in the mood for a bit of hard yakka. As long as I can have it to myself tomorrow.
Just hold on a second now. I'm the boss.
That's what she reckons.
When are you planning to go back?
Oh, later tomorrow. I've still got a few things I want to sort
out.
Well,
that settles it. The more help I give you today, the more time we'll have here together tomorrow. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
How was Wayne?
Thought you were asleep.
Just resting. How was he?
He's doing well with his hydrotherapy.
Good.
I'm glad you were sensible enough to knock his idea on the head.
He spoke to you about it, did he?
Trying to get me on side, but I agreed with you. It's impractical.
Why is that?
Well, it takes a bit more to organize that sort of thing than it does a charity ball.
I see. You're going to do it, are you?
I don't want the extra responsibility.
Seems to be becoming your catchphrase these days.
Until Wayne's up to it himself, I'll hire somebody. Fiona's helping with bits and pieces, but she's not really suitable either.
I'm lumped together with Fiona, am I? Not really suitable.
The project requires somebody who's capable of organizing, giving orders, coordinating. Somebody who's familiar with workers.
Which means Wayne is lumbered with the expense of an extra salary.
You don't get anything for nothing these days.
He would if you did it.
I can't afford the time away from the city.
Oh.
I'm sick to the back teeth with them, Patricia.
What are you talking about?
The sly dig's about me taking it easy.
If the cab fits.
Oh, for God's sake, go ahead and do it. It'll be a complete schmozzle. But at least it'll keep you out of my sight for a while.
And what makes you think it'd be a schmozzle?
Because you're not experienced enough to make it anything but.
I just might surprise you.
I doubt it.
I'm capable of being a lot more than Mrs. Gordon Hamilton, you know.
Well, I should hope so. You didn't make a very good fist of that.
There's absolutely nothing left, is there?
I thought we decided that the other night.
I'll talk it through with Wayne. If he's still keen, I'll go straight down to Woombye tomorrow.
You don't have to prove anything to me.
Oh, I'm not trying to. I don't want any more arguments, Charlie. Yesterday with Gordon was quite enough.
Well, who's arguing? All I said was, good on you.
It was the way you said it.
Well, I'm glad you've woken up to yourself.
I'm going down to Woombye for four reasons. To get as far away from Gordon as I possibly can, to prove to myself I can do the job, and to show you and any of the crowd that you might have discussed it with that I can be around David without falling all over him.
Oh, you know it's something I wouldn't bandy about.
I'm sorry. All right, to show you I can do it.
For?
Oh, to try and settle my differences with John.
Is he down there?
No, I'm going over to see him now. I'll need some help, and Gordon's agreed to release him from the stud.
I see.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you're really making sure you don't do anything, aren't you? Well, with David down there and John alongside him, the chances of splendor in the grass become minimized, don't they?
I'll see you when I get back.
Oh. When will that be? Around lunchtime?
I mean, from Woombye. As I said, don't want any more arguments.
I hope it all works out. All nonsense aside.
All right. If I get into trouble, I'll ring you.
You do that.
Oh, I'm aware I'll be taking on a lot. I'll be overseeing both projects, the building of the stable and the renovation of Fiona's. I'll have to liaise between tradesmen, workers, the architect, see the local council about the state of the approach road to the property, or whatever Wayne wants.
What would I be doing?
I'll need as much help as I can get. I'm not sure exactly. Just be there when I need you.
I don't know.
I think the reason you're hesitating is the reason you ought to go. Us. Up there, hopefully, we can get things sorted out. Just because two people don't see eye to eye, it doesn't mean they can't get on. Getting away from Sydney, working together. Besides, your father's up there. It'd be good for you to spend some time with him.
What about you two?
We got on perfectly well the day of the barbecue. There's no reason why we shouldn't up there.
Okay. When do we leave?
seen my car keys?
On top of the fridge.
Cheryl said Stevie didn't sleep. He was so excited.
You called her?
Yeah, just to make sure everything's okay. It's really good of you setting this up.
I'm glad I was able to. Cheryl doesn't mind you having him for an extra day.
No, she's glad to see him so happy. All she is worried about is how much you told the people from the channel.
I stressed he doesn't know how sick he is, and they promised not to let anything slip.
You think we can trust him?
I'm sure you can. They're really nice people.
I reckon it's worth the risk. See your mum and dad.
Bye.
Coming. How do you do? Heather Bradshaw. I work in PR at Channel 7.
Oh, you're here about this afternoon?
That's right.
Oh, come in.
Thank you.
Come through.
I was hoping to speak to Mr. Ryan.
Oh, Mick doesn't live here.
Oh, this is the address they gave me.
Oh, this is where he's bringing his little boy.
Stevie?
Yeah, right. He and Stevie's mother are separated, so they're using our place for Norm's visit.
Oh, I see. What time are you expecting him back?
Well, in an hour or so.
Ah. Look, I'll give you my card. If you could get him to call me. The news department heard about it and they want to do a human interest story, but under the circumstances, we thought we'd better check with Mr. Ryan first.
Okay, well, I'll give it to him as soon as he arrives.
Certainly makes you realize how lucky you are when you come across something like this. I've got a little boy of my own. I don't know how I'd cope.
I don't understand.
The illness. How would you tell a child of seven you could be dead in a couple of months? Well, it's been so nice meeting you. I'll be expecting Mr. Ryan's call.
Hello, you frightened me. How are you, Tiger?
Hi.
Guess who called?
Norm, eh?
That's right. He said that everything's okay and he wants to see you out by the gate when he arrives.
Beauty, eh, mate?
Yeah.
Why don't you go out now, just in case?
Go on, off you go. Don't play outside the gate, though. You should have heard him on the way over. He's told every kid in the neighbourhood. Cheryl reckons he's the local hero. What other kid gets a special meeting with Norm the kangaroo?
Why didn't you tell me? A woman came from the channel. She wants you to ring her about a news story. She told me about Stevie.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I didn't want too many people knowing.
I understand. It's just a bit of a shock, that's all. I won't stay around for this afternoon and blow everything. Just about started crying when he came in.
Susie said I should have told you.
It's a bit of getting used to, that's all. Never had to handle anything like this before. I'll make up some excuse on my way out. Hope it all goes right.
Angela.
It's okay, really. Any sign of him?
No.
Should be along any minute now. Will you say hello to him for me?
Where are you going?
A friend wants to see me.
Who?
Just a friend. Don't mind, do you?
Don't you want to see Norm?
Well, I'll try to, but if I'm not back before he goes, don't worry, will you? Okay?
Okay.
Listen to you. Told her the night I took her to the pictures.
She was in a room, it's when she walked past me.
Who wouldn't be? Having a thing like that dumped on you.
Stevie's disappointed she's not going to be around.
What'd he say?
Oh, it was just the way he mentioned she wasn't going to be here. He didn't want to speak to me at first, because of the other night.
Oh, right. You sorted it out then?
Oh, all it needed was for me to say I was sorry I yielded him.
Yeah, he's good like that. Doesn't hold grudges.
Did you ring that woman? The one from the channel?
Straight after Angie left. Told her we didn't want any publicity. She seemed fine about it.
Dad! Dad! Quick! No, I'm just going out of the class! Dad!
Come on.
you, mate.
Come on, mate. Where's your manners? Shake hands with Norm.
Yeah. Good to see you. Hey, Shirl and Possum said to give you their regards. You want to go for a ride? Jump on the back then. Come on. You right?
Hang on tight, Steve.
Here we go.
Here
we go. Oh. Are you all right? You okay? Oh, I'm not helping you. Oh. Well, get it back around this way. Are you on?
Yep.
Where are we then? Woo-hoo-hoo!
There you go. You have a sleep now, okay? It was fun today, wasn't it?
Yeah. How come Angela's not back?
I don't know. I suppose she got tied up. You'll have lots to tell her next time you see her, though, won't you?
Yeah.
You go to sleep now. Sue and I'll just be in here.
Dad, you know what I'm gonna do?
Go to sleep, I hope.
When I grow up and drive trucks like you, I'm gonna sing them all the time.
Yeah, sure you will.
I'm as full as a gugger. Pity we couldn't have it outside. It's one of the best things about the country. Catching flies in your mouth every time you open it. They taste good, don't they?
Sorry? Oh, yes. Yes, they do.
I was talking to myself. That's all right.
I've got a few things on my mind. Is there much work to be done outside?
Sure. Why?
Well, there's something important I want to talk about to Scott, and I was wondering if you wouldn't mind finding something to do outside when he arrives. I want to discuss it with him in here. It is connected with this place. And I'd feel happier if it was in here. I'm sorry, David, I can't tell you about it. It's much too personal.
Oh, no worries. I'll make myself scarce as soon as he arrives. That sounds like him now. I'll leave you to it. Are you sure you're okay?
Ask me that same question in half an hour's time.
You're only going down there to get away from me. Why not go for a holiday, wherever you like? I'll pay for it.
Getting worried about your investment, are you? Think I'll waste your money?
When I told you to do it yesterday, I was angry. I didn't mean it.
And that's supposed to make me change my mind.
Well, I was hoping...
I will not be fobbed off like some vacuous divorcee in the making. I don't want an overseas trip. This is a good start to a life on my own. I'll be able to prove to myself that I'm capable of doing something more constructive than being your wife. Mind you, I don't think that was Wayne's intention. I think he thought some time away from each other might help. Bit of a pipe dream, wouldn't you say?
Yes.
Right on time.
Ready?
Ready.
I thought it was about time you knew it all. 30 years is a long time to hide something like that.
Why? If you knew the baby was coming, why didn't you say something? It would have made a difference.
I decided to finish it months before we separated. I made sure I was pregnant first. I knew I could never marry you. If I couldn't have you, I wanted to have your baby.
But the arguments we had, the breakup, that was my decision.
You thought it was. I knew what I was doing. I knew you would never accept me ending it.
We loved each other. I would have married you. Why?
I was a prostitute. I knew you'd be very successful. There was no way we could marry. So I came down here. And I had the baby.
poor little mite. He was so weak. I had him for 3 days. I knew I would have to tell you eventually. I wouldn't blame you if you...
You're a remarkable woman, Fiona Thompson. Now I'd like to go and see my son's grave.
Goodbye.